What's up guys, it's Adam here. Now in this video we're going to talk about how to get a Singaporean IP address if you're out of the country. So if you're currently out of Singapore, then you'll probably know how difficult it is to access Singaporean services or content. Because of geo-blocking technologies, websites from Singapore can detect foreign IP addresses and block them accordingly. Fortunately, you can get around this by using a reliable VPN with servers in Singapore. As soon as you connect to one, you'll replace your actual IP address with a Singaporean one, which lets you bypass geo-blocks. You'll protect your data and stay anonymous, since a VPN has world-class security and privacy features. And you might even get an increase in speeds too, as bandwidth throttling is prevented. However, you can't just go around using any VPN randomly. Like all other digital services, VPNs are not equal and it can be difficult to choose the right one since there are so many of them out there. And this is where I come in. I've gone ahead and tested more than 30 of the most popular VPNs on the market to find three of the best ones that you can use to obtain a Singaporean IP address. Before anything else though, I'd like to talk more about why you need to get a VPN to get a Singaporean IP address in the first place. Simply put, people from Singapore can't access local websites and services when travelling, which is because of geo-blocking. The main reasons for geo-blocking are to protect licensing agreements and copyright. This means that you need to get a VPN with Singaporean servers to access websites and services from the country. This includes news sites, streaming services, sporting events, and local bank accounts. Connecting to a server in Singapore will redirect and encrypt your internet traffic, which gives you a Singaporean IP address in turn. When Singaporean websites see your new IP address, they'll think you're there and grant you access. Its military-grade encryption is especially handy on public Wi-Fi networks as it prevents malicious hackers from intercepting your data and stealing personal information. And with its strict no logs policy, a VPN will stop your online activity from being recorded. This means you can browse Singaporean websites anonymously and securely. Now that we've established that you do need a good VPN to get a Singaporean IP address, we can move on to my first recommendation, which is ExpressVPN. ExpressVPN is actually my favourite pick due to several reasons. One is that ExpressVPN has several server locations in Singapore, fast speeds and military-grade encryption. It even comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can test ExpressVPN servers in Singapore risk-free. If it's not for you, then you can ask for a refund. Another thing that I love about ExpressVPN is that its server speeds are lightning fast, making it ideal for streaming. When I tested speeds of its Singaporean services, I recorded an average download speed of 49.6 megabits per second. Only 5 megabits per second are needed for smooth HD streaming, so this was plenty. Additionally, it hides your IP address to prevent bandwidth throttling, which can further boost your speeds. I also like that ExpressVPN offers some world-class security features which do a great job at protecting your data. This includes AES 256-bit encryption for securing your connection, which is the strongest encryption level available. Added to this is a kill switch called network lock, which cuts you from the internet if you suddenly disconnect from your VPN. And with ExpressVPN's DNS and IP leak protection, your real IP address won't be exposed accidentally. ExpressVPN's server network consists of 3,000 servers across over 90 different countries, which includes Singapore. Its Singapore server locations are CBD, Jurong, and Marina Bay. This means you can easily access Singaporean websites from anywhere. When I connected to 5 of its Singaporean servers, it only took me less than 20 seconds to unblock Toggle and Singtel. There wasn't any manual configuration required either, as all I did was press a button. Of course, with ExpressVPN, your online identity and activity will be kept anonymous too, thanks to its strict no-logs policy and no-spy servers. These features stop your data from being recorded and wipe all of the server data after every reboot. Also, it's based in the British Virgin Islands, which is outside the 14 Eyes Alliance. I will put in the description section below a special discount so that you can get a better deal on ExpressVPN and gain some free months as well. Along with this, if you aren't ready to commit, then you can always test ExpressVPN servers in Singapore completely risk-free, as it's backed by a 30-day money-back guarantee. I've personally tested this policy by asking its live chat team to cancel my subscription after 30 days. They asked me a couple of questions before going ahead with my request, and I was refunded after 3 business days. Now, let's move on to my second VPN recommendation for getting a Singaporean IP address, which is none other than NordVPN. NordVPN is a solid choice of VPN for obtaining a Singapore IP address. It offers super fast speeds and easily unblocks geo-restricted content. Overall, NordVPN has an impressive 113 servers in Singapore and more than 5,700 others across 60 countries worldwide. This high quantity of servers is combined with high quality performance. Fast speed and unlimited bandwidth make NordVPN a good choice for streaming services such as Netflix and Amazon Prime Video. Further, NordVPN is great value because you can use it on up to 6 devices at once. During my testing, I found NordVPN's apps to be well designed and intuitive. Navigating servers is easy. Each listing displays the current server load and gives you the option to favour specific servers. Security is also strong, with NordVPN offering 256-bit AES encryption, DNS leak protection, and a kill switch. You can use NordVPN with peace of mind, as it has a no-logs policy and is based in Panama, where there is no mandatory data retention law. I also like that NordVPN is compatible with a wide range of devices and operating systems, including Windows, Mac, Linux, Android, iOS, and Android TV. Overall, NordVPN is a good choice for a VPN in general. It pegs amazing speeds and operates a huge network of servers, can be used on up to 6 devices simultaneously, and includes a 30-day money-back guarantee for a risk-free deal. And now for my third recommendation, which is Surfshark. Surfshark is a great low-cost VPN that's especially worth considering if you're planning on sharing your VPN with family. That's because it allows an unlimited number of simultaneous connections. Surfshark offers around 3,000 servers in 60 countries, including Singapore. It can be used to securely access all kinds of content, be it Netflix or Skype. Speeds are generally good for streaming, which means you can watch without interruption. In my testing, I found Surfshark very convenient to use thanks to the beginner-friendly app and browser extensions offered. There's also 24/7 live chat and email support, and a number of useful features such as an ad blocker. As for privacy features, Surfshark is headquartered in the British Virgin Islands and operates a strict no-logs policy. Security features include 256-bit AES encryption, a kill switch, and protection from DNS and IPv6 leaks. Like the other two VPNs on this list, Surfshark is compatible with most internet-capable devices and operating systems, including Windows, Mac, Android, iOS, and Amazon Fire TV. Overall, Surfshark is a good budget option for users looking to share their VPN service with their family, since it supports an unlimited number of devices. Despite its lower price point, Surfshark has all the essentials covered, including multiple servers in Singapore and dozens of other countries. No logs VPN with 24/7 support and a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can test it risk-free. So before I end this video, I'd like to answer a few questions that I often get about this topic. For the first question, is obtaining a Singaporean IP address legal? Yes, it is. Using a VPN to obtain a Singaporean IP address is perfectly legal. A VPN works by redirecting your traffic through a private server, which protects your connection and bypasses geo-blocks. It's also a good idea to use one when you're in Singapore, as the country is big on internet censorship. You've just got to be careful in countries that either ban or restrict VPN use, such as China, Russia, and Belarus. For the next question, how else can you get a Singaporean IP address? Well, other options are to use a proxy server or smart DNS service, but a VPN with robust security features is much better because it bypasses geo-blocks and encrypts your connection. Both a proxy server and smart DNS service unblock geo-restricted content by letting you use a Singaporean IP address, but lack the security features of a VPN. Now, the third and final question, should you use a free VPN to get a Singaporean address? Well, I'd strongly recommend against this idea and recommend using a top-tier VPN with a money-back guarantee instead. Free VPNs may seem enticing, but actually they carry a lot of risk. For example, many of them lack security features and are known to record your activity and sell it to advertisers who then target you with ads whilst you use their service. This is how free VPNs make their money. A lot of them also have speed and data caps and restrict the number of servers offered. In fact, most of them won't have any servers in Singapore at all. So, thank you so much for watching my video. If you are interested in any of the VPNs I mentioned in the video, I will put a special discount link that I was able to get for you guys in the description area below so that you can save some money. If you have any questions, leave a comment and don't forget to like my video if you found this review helpful. And subscribe to my channel if you want to be up to date on the latest VPNs.